According to the organization Campaign for Youth Justice, every year, juvenile courts in the U.S. handle an estimated 1.6 million cases in which the youth was charged with a delinquency offense. 70% of youth in detention are held for nonviolent charges. More than two-thirds are charged with property offenses, public order offenses, technical probation violations, or status offenses. Lawyer Mercedes Cano says in an ideal world, a young person should be judged based on the evidence of the case. But sometimes it does not happen, especially when it comes to minorities.
If you have a black person going before a jury and the charges are rape, assault, the jury is already poisoned, if you could call it that way, or prejudiced against black people. It happens the same thing with Spanish people.
In some states, minors can be sentenced to life imprisonment without the possibility of parole. An estimated 200,000 youth are tried, sentenced, or incarcerated as adults every year across the United States. Lawyer Cano explains, most of the time, this happens with minorities due to the lack of information and also lack of money.
Lack of information as to what to do. You are entitled to an attorney if you have no money. You are entitled to fight the charges if you're innocent. But also because lack of money. If you don't have money to pay for a private attorney, you know, you're really the alternatives to fight against the case are limited to whatever the system can give you.
Attorney Cano believes the system should change its current practices and invest in education rather than punishment.
If we don't invest in our young people, later on, we're gonna have a population that is gonna be criminal, resentful, uneducated, and they're gonna keep committing crimes. We're not gonna go anywhere like that.
The country currently spends $50 billion on its jails, and there are projects and systems in place to address the issue of overcrowding. The problem is that each state has its own rehabilitation systems.